Going to the nail spa for hand and foot treatments can be really nice, but it's also taking a toll on your pockets. Not only we're spending money on the manicures, the pedicures, and the enhancements, some of these things that they use on our hand and foot treatments is quite similar to some of the stuff that we put on our face and bodies. And these are some of the practices that I follow myself for past a decade. And not only has it saved me money, and it's actually kept my skin in pretty good condition. So I'm just going to go through each and every one of them. The first one is I always slap on lotion after I take my baths and showers, and my skin has been pretty smooth since then. I've been doing it since when I was 14, and I can't really complain too much about my skin at this point. It's quite good. Even the fine lines aren't too visible. The only thing is, now during winter times, I actually put a thicker lotion on my hands and on my feet, and I would slip on gloves and socks and just keep it on for maybe an hour or two. Now, when I take those off, my hands and feet are like so silky smooth, and it works each and every time. And you don't need to spend a lot of money on that because that's stuff that you have at home already. And second is I would put some of my face products onto my hands. So, for example, when I slap on my toner, I would actually put some on my hands as well because I just noticed that, for example, our face, we need, for especially for Asians, we need that whitening effect. And my toner does that, my moisturizer does that, and my serum does that. However, our hands don't really get that every day. I do get that from the nail spa every now and then, but again, I don't go every day. I got this lotion just a while ago from Vaseline. It has like a whitening effect. So that proves that our hands actually needs to be whitened too. So I guess maybe I'm doing something right by putting my toner and my face lotion onto my hands as well. Because again, I'm not so good. I don't really use this every day, which I think I should. Okay, and the next one is exfoliation. Now I get this exfoliant is from Kusho. I paid about US$14 for it, and it's quite a big bottle. It's like 240 milliliters. However, I found that my face scrub, this is from Neutrogena, and it's about the same price. However, why do I have to get two separate scrubs when I can just use this one for my hands? The stuff that it does is actually quite the same. The beads, like their roughness and their size is about the same. And the number, like the concentration of the beads inside, it actually feels quite the same. Actually, I would have to say this one is a little bit more gentle. So when I give my face a scrub during my shower, I would actually go over my hands, over my feet, and over my elbows and knees as well, and my ankles. And so I think that does quite a good job because I was looking on the bottle in terms of what it does. I think actually the face scrub actually does more than this. So it's really interesting. And the next one is cuticle oil. I mentioned that in my other post already, but don't forget that. Remember, I have a cuticle oil pen that I just kind of bring everywhere. There's one here sitting by my desk. There's one in my purse. There's one in my car. So what happens is I just paint it on my cuticle area whenever I remember. I do it on my toes as well, and it just keeps it really nice. I'm quite free of hangnails, so I'm really thankful for that. Because it can get really, really dry. And next is Vaseline. It's cheap, and I think most households actually have a tub of Vaseline. I just use it over my lips before I sleep. I keep it on my cuticles if it's super duper dry, or even sometimes over my knuckles. Same thing for my toes and heels. And then I would slip my gloves and socks on. I would go to sleep with it. And same thing, boom, the next morning, I just wash off or wipe off the excess, and you're so good to go. So that's really good. It's a cheap and a very traditional alternative to a lot of masks that we use. Next is sunscreen. I know we always put it on our face and neck, but don't forget, our hands actually get exposed to the sun just as much. And a lot of people actually neglect it. So after putting the sunscreen or the sunblock on my face, I would actually put it onto my hands. And in the summertime, when I wear flip-flops, I would actually cover my feet and my toes in sunblock as well. There's a lot we can do for our face. I know a lot of people pay a lot of attention to the whitening part, to hiding the imperfections or the blemishes, the laser treatments. But I don't think a lot of people do it for their hands. And as we age, we'll get the little brown spots. That's either from aging or previous sun damage. And people don't really take that effort to prevent it in the first place. And it's actually quite easy. Just have that practice of going over your hands after using the same product for your face. It's just simple as that. Next is nail polish. This one I found it's really good. At home, there's always some funky eyeshadow that's sitting around somewhere that I'm not throwing out because I don't know when I'll need it next, but I ended up not really touching it. It's really funky colors. For example, like pink, like really hot pink. Maybe it came in a bundle or something. Never touched it. Hey, but I learned that you can actually scrape it or crush it and then put it in a bottle of clear nail polish and just shake it up like crazy. You'll end up with really nice nail polish. Now I can use pink nail polish on my toes. I use it in summertime all the time. I even had people ask me what color my nail polish was, and in fact, it's just the color of my really weird eyeshadow. Same thing with glitters. Glitters don't really cost that much. You can make your glitter eye sorry, nail polish just like that. Add it in and just shake it up like crazy. You just gotta play with the proportions a little bit. And next, this is for those of you who do like DIY gel nail stuff at home, or even with just gel polishes. A lot of people are doing that at home right now. Before, I would used to buy things like this. This is from NSI. It's their gel cleaner. It's their cleanse. For a 2 ounce bottle, it's about like $4 to $5 that I buy online, and it's quite expensive. And I just realized that to clean that sticky, that tacky layer from the top of my nail after when I'm done curing, I can actually use like alcohol. Like I have alcohol prep pads at home, and these are like really cheap. It's like a few cents each. I can even use just regular alcohol with cotton, but I just like these better. But it works the same. You can actually remove that tacky layer with alcohol, so it works perfect. So I'm gonna say goodbye to this. Once I'm done, I'm not gonna buy anymore. So that's really good. And next is a serum. I got this from Kusho as well. This tiny little bottle right here. It's about $11 US. It's a lemon skin lightening serum. As I say, some of our skin products for face actually have that lightening effect already, so there's no point of getting it for our hands all over again. This is from Kiehl's. This is a line reducing eye brightening concentrate. The reason why I chose the eye one is because this one actually did a really good job at taking out the fine lines, which I was starting to develop around these areas. And again, it did a pretty good job at taking them out, and this is just a sample that I got, and it actually lasted me for about a good three four times for my hands, so it's really good. So that saved my money right there. So again, when I'm done, I'm not gonna buy any more of this, so goodbye to that. And next is a face mask. I know a lot of us still use the ones from the tub, or the ones that's come from a jar, or even the disposable ones that come like in a paper mask. It doesn't really matter, but the point is to put the remnants on your hand. So after you kind of put the stuff on your face, whatever's left on your hands, just kind of massage it like over your hands. Or even for the disposable ones, when you have a sheet of paper mask, there's always that serum that's inside the package. So squeeze that out and apply it onto your hands. Slip it into like plastic gloves, or even your dishwashing gloves, or even the disposable plastic gloves. It doesn't matter. Just keep it in there for a while, and it'll do the same thing. So it's really good for your hands as well. And next, I will talk about orange wood sticks. I know these things aren't really that expensive, but for me, because I do a lot of nail art on my own and I experiment and I just kind of mess around with the stuff at home, and I use it for a number of stuff. Sometimes to pick up rhinestones, to scrape the side clean, or even to use it as a stirring stick. And sometimes I run out of these things just when I need it the most. And I noticed that it's actually much more cheaper when I buy it in thousands, but of course I don't really need that much. So what happens is when this thing gets dirty or dull, I would just take another nail file and I would actually reshape it into actually file that that part that I just used, whichever part it was. For example, if it had nail polish on it, I'll just file it off. Or if there's like glitters with glue or whatnot stuck on it, I'll just, you know, shape it again and make it flat and nice again, so it's good to go. So same thing on this side, I can just kind of file it away. So it's really good. One stick actually lasted me forever. So that's that. And next, oh, this is a really good one. Actually, it's one of my favorites. This is, let's see if you can see it from here. This is just the cotton that I use to remove my makeup. And I realized that it's really good for doing two things. One is to remove the really, really stubborn nail polish or the glitter nail polish. So what I do is I cut it into very, very small pieces. For example, like this. See this square right here? So what I do is I actually soak this in a nail polish remover, and the nail polish remover that I use is the purple one from OPI. That one's really good with removing stubborn nail polishes or the ones with glitters. So what I do is I soak it, and then I actually put it over the nail. And there's one of two things that you can do. You can just kind of keep it there and maybe wait for a good 30 seconds. Or if you have tin foil, just cut it into maybe like a 5 centimeter by 5 centimeter square and just wrap it up and just wait. And then once you wait for maybe 30 seconds to a minute, just remove it and then take another piece, doesn't matter what size, and just slightly go over it with nail polish remover and you're good. So you don't have to keep scrubbing back and forth to get rid of that really stubborn nail polish. So that'll save you a lot of time and hassle, because I notice that my nail polish remover and my cottons go really, really quick when I'm just scrubbing it and just keep drenching it with my nail polish remover. It's a waste. And also same thing for soak off gels. Doesn't matter if you're doing it DIY or if you're doing it at a salon. It's always nice to know that you can actually remove it yourself, but you just got to be a little bit more careful. So same thing, you take acetone or the purple OPI nail polish remover, get this all dampened, and then just put it on top of your enhancement and wrap it with the tin foil. Depending on how thick they actually had it on, maybe just check back every 5 to 10 minutes at every 5 minute intervals and take an orange wood stick. I would use this one instead of the metal scraper that they use for pushing cuticles. Just use it and push it in this direction, pushing outwards. Try not to do it at too sharp of an angle, because don't forget that your nails can be a little bit soft and maybe brittle or fragile from that soaking. So if you're pushing at a really sharp angle, you might damage your nail bed. So just go at an angle and push that softened gel off. You should be able to do it quite easily. If not, don't just get at it, because it'll really hurt your nails. Just re-soak it, put the cotton back on, put the foil on, and just repeat that process. It should come off really easily. And last is to get your nail polish to last a long time is, for example, let me see. This is my nail polish, the Crackle one. And I know a lot of people take their nail polish and shake it like that. I do it sometimes for a few reasons. One, that metal bead in there just won't move. It's because it's been sitting there for a long time and it just won't move. So I have to shake it, or if the glitter just won't move. But usually, generally, I'll turn it upside down and I'll roll it like this. This way, you're not actually creating a lot of air bubbles. You don't even have to turn it upside down if it's not that stubborn. Just roll it. So that way, you're not turning the air bubbles inside and just flipping around and evaporating or even drying out your nail polish. So this actually makes it last much longer. So keep that in mind. And again, if you got anything to add to the list, just write to us. Don't forget, we're at nailaddicts with a Z.com.